The Grassley Wyden bill that you heard me talk about, and I didn't go into depth about it. It's got 38 parts, but the main part of it is, repeating again, no year-over-year increase in cost, in increase in medicine by the pharmaceutical companies more than the CPI. But other parts of it, it would put a cap on year, what one person has to spend out of pocket. It would also save the taxpayers $95 billion. It would save the consumer, the seniors, $72 billion. It would get into this whole thing of reforming pharmacy benefit managers, PBMs. It also has an insulin provision in to keep insulin prices down. And by the way, when I first became chairman of the Finance Committee, the first hearing I had was bringing in the three insulin companies and raking them over the coals about the fabulous increase in prices.
We have the best medical providers, institutions of learning, equipment, facilities in the world. Yet we perhaps have one of the less efficient systems. And it doesn't help that we have political animus, that one person's political party is advantaged by seeing the detriment to the medical system, which you can blame on the other party. It's really, it's not self-serving. It doesn't serve our population at all. I would like to see a system where everyone can go to the hospital, can go to see their provider, and not go through the rigmarole of how to pay for it, where it is substantially free.